Dr. Mark Smith. I'm a neurosurgeon and president of Carolina Neurosurgery and Spine Associates. I'm also vice chief of outpatient operations for SpineFirst. So minimally invasive surgery is a procedure designed to protect the normal anatomy of the spine while we correct the anatomic abnormality that's causing the pain, which is a technical way of saying that we save the tissues that can be saved and only treat the abnormalities. For spine, minimally invasive surgical options apply in multiple different areas. So we can do both anterior and posterior approaches in the lumbar and thoracic spine, as well as posterior approaches in the cervical spine. So those procedures are designed to treat the specific problem that the patient has. So minimally invasive surgery for a patient is designed to help that patient recover more quickly than could otherwise happen with an open or more traditional surgical technique. So those surgeries are designed to be as effective as open or traditional techniques, but with less tissue damage and thus less recovery time for the patient. So risks of minimally invasive spine surgery are at similar rates or less than open surgeries. Risks of any spine procedure are blood loss, infection, instrumentation failure, need for additional surgeries. Many of those risks are lessened in minimally invasive surgery due to the tissue preservation techniques. We have patients prepare for minimally invasive spine surgery just as you would any traditional open surgery. Patients need to be healthy preoperatively. They need to be medically stable, and we often utilize our primary care physician colleagues to help us. Patients should expect after a minimally invasive spine procedure to have relief of the pain that has brought them to us. We spend a significant amount of time on diagnosis, and when we have a correct diagnosis, we do the correct procedure for that, then pain relief should be fairly rapid. So almost any patient requiring a spinal procedure could be evaluated for a minimally invasive alternative if they've been offered an open procedure. There's some anatomic abnormalities that we have difficulty treating in minimally invasive scenarios, such as long segment deformities of the spine or multi-level abnormalities that might require an open approach. But in most cases, there are often minimally invasive alternatives. There are occasional situations where minimally invasive spine surgery would not be an option. Those scenarios are based on the anatomy of the spine and the length and location of the pain generators in the spine. So it's up to us as the physicians to evaluate patients in a thorough and detailed manner, so that we can make an appropriate surgical plan. So many times when we're discussing minimally invasive surgical options with patients, we're differentiating between what could be a large open procedure or an attempt at a smaller procedure that would be less destructive, but alternatively offer significant pain relief. And in those situations, patients will often try a less invasive option and avoid a larger surgery, which would have more risks, much longer recovery, and significantly more pain in the postoperative period. So minimally invasive surgeries for spine patients have a couple of different advantages, which are very clear. The first is the recovery time. You know, recovery from a minimally invasive operation is much quicker, and patients have less pain, they're mobile earlier, less pain medications are required, and all those factors lead to a quicker recovery. They're well demonstrated to have fewer complications in regard to infections, which is a great benefit. Infection after spine surgery can be, you know, quite debilitating for patients. And also significantly less blood loss. And those factors all put together make those surgeries very attractive in appropriate situations. Minimally invasive options are available to patients if you're being evaluated in a comprehensive way by a team of physicians that has both the ability to do minimally invasive and more traditional open techniques. So without the comprehensive evaluation, then the patient might not hear all the options that are available. So we have a team of physicians here that specializes in minimally invasive procedures. We also have great surgeons who do open techniques. We often discuss patients amongst ourselves to come up with the best treatment plan. One minimally invasive surgery that we perform routinely is minimally invasive fusion. And just as an example, this is a model of the spine. And we can actually place these screws on both sides and accomplish a fusion within the disc here through 2 1-inch incisions, whereas previously we had to make a long 6-inch incision in the midline and remove all the important musculature away from the bone, and that creates additional tissue damage and weakness in the spine. A technique that we use for minimally invasive surgery involves placement of a small tubular retractor. Think of laparoscopic surgery as an example. We make a small incision in the back and then place the larger tubes down to the bony anatomy of the spine so that we can operate in a space that's about 18 millimeters in diameter rather than make a large 3 or 4 inch incision. That spares the musculature of the spine, decreases pain postoperatively, and retain some of the significant structure of the spine so that there's less risk down the road for more problems.